Hello, I'm Mr. R. Raja, a retired lecturer of metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. And here I'm going to give you part two, the difference between disciples and laborers. In Christ Jesus, we had laborers and not disciples. Disciples are like school children who go to learn letters. Letters are scriptures. So those people who learn scriptures, they go to their schoolmasters. So rabbis are schoolmasters. So under the watchful eye of the rabbis, they are taught these letters, law. But the temperance of the law are the spirituality aspect is kept in the hand of the rabbi himself. Because if he gives them the spirituality as well to the school children, then they can misuse the spirituality and cause chaos. So to avoid that one, the misuse of that one, so the rabbi only gives them the letters. The spirituality or the knowledge of the oral Torah is normally given to the adult people who are sensible enough to understand the prayers of God and how to handle them. Children are not sensible enough to handle them. That's why those people who bring little children to Christ Jesus, the laborers of Jesus rebuked them. Look, we can't understand what he is saying. How can the little children understand it? Then through little children, Jesus stressed that unless your heart is unbiased and impartial as that those of the little children, you cannot enter into the royal kingdom of God. So, in the Jesus described his work as the laborers he hired in the vineyard of God. Remember the parable that in the evening the master comes, he asks the foreman, come, give your laborers their wage. So he gives them the same to everyone. That wage was given at Pentecost, and that was Holy Spirit. So we work in the vineyard of God, and our aim is to obtain our wage, which is Holy Spirit with capital S. And when we attain that wage, then we become the twin brethren of Christ Jesus and the apostles, or all the Christs of the world. So, in the vineyard, you can't employ school children who have no sense, or who cannot work of their own. But under the supervision of those people who have sense and who can guide them, they are allowed. Like of the 12 laborers, one of them was childlike, and that was Peter. But as Peter was having the watchful eye of the Christ Jesus and those of the apostles who tolerated him, and they kept as a family. So same in churches, you will find that there are people who are simple-minded people like Peter, and the people who are sensible, they should tolerate them. And it is these simple-minded people who work hard to feed the congregation. So that's why Christ Jesus stressed Peter, "Will you feed my sheep?" So Peter, being once born, in the churches you can find that some people doing cooking, feeding, making food, preparing food, distributing, washing dishes, everything. That also form part of the family. They are rendering service as the anybody else. They are part of our body. But so far they remain part of our body. We are united. And to remain part of the body, you need head also to think it over. If you don't have the head, then the body without head or headless body cannot think, and then you will disperse like blind people. So you need to have eye, third eye, to guide the congregation. So third eye is by the grace of our Father God. So nobody can have it without His grace. So we should have in the congregation people who are spiritual. And these spiritual people are produced when the apostle used to visit the churches and sow the seed of his word. As I stressed earlier, the Messianic Jews, they corrupted the churches. And when the apostle used to come and rebuke them, they told them, "If you want to rebuke me, don't come to my church. Do what I tell you to do." They said, "Our praises lie with our Father, not with you." So they left the churches. Remember that this church in Jerusalem was the one which was corrupted, which became corrupt under the influence of those Jews from the temple. So that's why they bring in this written Torah into the Bible or into their church, which was highly objected by the other churches, because this was the Jewish leaven which should not be brought into the church, as Jesus has stressed. So the result is there. They were killing the Messianic Jews when they became bishops and had the influence with the Romans. They start to kill people who taunted them or who raised their voices against them. As the Pope was killing those and burning them to stake, anybody who opens his mouth against what he has said. So Pope is the greatest antichrist on the earth. And his bishops and all those, they created havoc in the world. And so the Gentile had a limit to which they could stay. So then the Gentile rose their head and organized and fought against this antichrist. The greatest havoc caused led to the appearance of the second anointed Christ, Nanak, in India, who preached the same thing as Christ Jesus did. So Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, but hardly anyone knows, because hardly anyone knows that Jesus did not have disciples. Disciples are like school children. So if this is the knowledge the people have, then how can they discern the Christ, first anointed Christ, never mind the second anointed Christ, Nanak? The Sikhism is the worst today, and so they are not awakened either. So they become Sikhs of turban and beard, and then being false sex, they get killed.